This video kicks off my lecture series on the mathematical concept of convolution. It's a widely used tool in physics, mathematics, and engineering. And in art, there would be no heavy metal guitar licks without the art of convolution. Oh, and photography, of course. Instagram filters and cat-detecting artificial intelligence rely heavily on convolution. But now I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's start from the very basics. Let's take a really simple signal to work with. I collect a time series by measuring temperatures at 1 second intervals. We will then see that the results are closely connected to the process called convolution. I place a regular kitchen thermometer in ice water. The temperature is 0 degrees centigrade. Sorry, Fahrenheit lovers, this channel uses the metric system. Then I suddenly move the meter from 0 degree ice water into 100 degree boiling water. On the left, there is water with ice cubes. On the right, there is a kettle with boiling water. The iPad is for timing, and the probe of the kitchen thermometer is placed in ice water. The meter shows 1 degree centigrade. Theoretically, ice water should be 0 degrees. What's going on here? Well, measurement devices are never perfect. The mathematics we develop needs to be flexible enough to produce good results even when there are errors in the data. So, let's just go ahead and measure. At 4 seconds, I quickly move the probe from ice water into the boiling water. The temperature measured by the thermometer starts to rise. However, the temperature rises in sudden steps, maintaining the same reading for a couple of seconds and then jumping up a lot. Let's examine our situation in detail. Ideally, we would be measuring 0 degrees at 1, 2, 3, and 4 seconds, since then the probe is in ice water. At 5 seconds, the probe is already in boiling water, so the perfect measurement would be 100. And since the probe remained in boiling water, we should have gotten 100 degrees more and more, no matter how long we measure. Except if the water boils out and only the kettle is left. But let's not care about that right now. What did we actually measure? Here are the temperatures picked out of the video footage shown in blue. The ideal measurement is shown in the background in gray for comparison. Our thermometer reported something quite different than the expected signal. It was a bit slow to pick up the development in temperature, but it did reach 100 degrees eventually at 44 seconds. We can use convolution as a mathematical model for our measurement. Let me explain that in a simplified situation. Here are the first 10 data points in our measurement. The ideal signal is a vector with 10 elements. The first 4 elements are zeros, and all the remaining 6 elements are equal to 100. Now see how a red filter is moving along the ideal signal, producing a new blue signal shown in the bottom plot. The blue signal builds up step by step at the location of the center element of the filter, marked with a square. The blue signal is called the convolution between the ideal signal and the filter. Let's study in detail what's happening here. I will concentrate on position 6. the values of the filter are percentages summing up to 1. Now multiply the first matching elements of filter and signal. It gives 0. Multiply the second matching elements of filter and signal. Add the new result. Multiply the third matching elements and add. Multiply the fourth matching elements and add. And the three remaining filter elements produce only zeros. The sum adds up to 90, and that's the value of convolution at position 6. A similar calculation is needed for all the 10 positions. We saw how convolution served as a model for building up a similar signal than the one I measured in my kitchen. However, there are crucial differences between my mathematical explanation and the actual measurement. First of all, in the simple model with a filter with only 3 non-zero elements, the temperature reached 100 degrees in only 7 seconds. In contrast, the actual measurement needed 44 seconds to go up to 100. So, a longer filter is needed for modeling the real data. But how long exactly? Also, in the simple model, the blue graph jumped up from 0 already at 5 seconds. The real data did the jump in 10 seconds. How should this difference show up in the filter? Can you construct a filter that reproduces the measured data by convolution? Let me know in the comments below. I will include the measured numbers below in the video description. Now, why would we build a convolution model for the measurement? One possible reason is that we could use deconvolution to recover the ideal measurement from the data we've got. That way we could improve the performance of our imperfect thermometer using mathematics. Deconvolution is actually an inverse problem with specific difficulties arising from ill-posedness. I will explain that stuff in a later lecture series about deconvolution. This was the first video in my lecture series on convolution. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and click like below. And please subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so you won't miss the next lecture. See you next time!